I'm not going to worry about the top right now. That's something we may trim or just bend a little bit more. We go down here, and starting right about there, and there. Now that's a really good start. Because it's a pretty straight shot anyway, you know, you got curves in one direction and straight in the other, and what that tells you, you haven't really changed the surface area of this at all, because we're not stretching it or shrinking it. We're simply forming it. You would want to trim this so that the flare panel was in the middle of this piece of square stock. Then when you weld it, you use a MIG welder and basically zap it a series of tack welds, letting it cool each time, and then another series of tack welds spaced far apart so the panel never feels real warm. If you're having trouble deciding how many pieces it's going to take to make a flare, it has a lot to do with your paper pattern and how easy it is to make it lay down. The metal will respond in pretty much the same way. So if you have you're trying to do too much with one big piece and you're getting the metals buckling up and it won't go where you want it to go without some popping up somewhere else, that tells you you're using too few pieces. Another reason we might want to use this method is because you can actually get the metal out where, pretty close to where you want it very quickly this way, whereas the stretching method takes a long time to get 2 or 3 inches out.